Yeah. So we're not going to edit anything.
Okay.
It's just going to be whatever you say.
Okay.
Oh, I know it.
You're doing great.
Oh, you actually believe me? It actually makes me nervous.
I have been a school administrator for almost 7.5 years. No, that's incorrect. We're in our 8th year. Yes, it'll be 7.5.
Oh gosh, sorry.
Okay, this is why we need to cut things. Okay.
Wait, what's the 3 questions? Age, is it number? I mean,
no.
Name.
Name, where you're from.
Where you're from.
And how long you've been.
Okay, great, let's start all over.
Hey, I'm Austin.
Okay, great. Cool.
Hey, I'm Mitchell.
I'm Carl.
We made this video.
We did.
Classroom becomes a nice little microcosm to equip people with the ability to go and to serve and to make difference in the world. And this community, this school, is not just solely about just giving you a degree or pushing you on to learning academic things, but pushing you on to be more like Christ.
I think when people first think, like, I'm going to school in Nashville, I think they just perceive it as like a bunch of Jason Aldean type, like, folks just like, I don't know, like, rebel flags that love Jesus, maybe. I think that's like the impression. But it's definitely not that. The diversity of people that I met at the Institute, dude, they're from like all over the parts of the U.S. and even other places around the world.
But when you couple the friendship that you develop and learning the Word of God together with those things, it creates like this like unbreakable combination. Friendships that I'll have till I die, not just because like we got along with each other and we had similar like interest, but because like we were able to bring that bond with the Word of God together, and it was so remarkable. So I think for people that are coming here, get ready to develop friends and just have some really meaningful times with each other.
Cool.
Yeah, I got your answer. Okay, so something that I think that they're gonna get pretty shocked by is how emotional the classes are.
Pray for them and the struggles that she went through. We may not know what she prayed, but we know the one who does. This is why it's so important for us to surrender to God and do what he says, because when we do what he says, we become at peace with even what he's been doing in our family. I want you to think of this.
People cry in these classes because they're just so good. And when you teach and the Spirit of God is with you, like you can see that in the scriptures. When Jesus is teaching and the Spirit is with him, there's power that comes forward. And that type of power is like transformative and redeeming. And it's like a power-packed times that you just don't expect to happen, you know, in a classroom setting, because you've been having classroom settings all your life. But when you come, I don't think they're ready for it, you know? And if they do, they're like, oh my gosh, these classes are so heavy. I'm like, yeah, dude. Yeah, it would take 5 years of that. That's what I did. Death is
a lie. What's been consistent is that my teachers have always cared for me, and not just as any random student in their classroom, but they know my name, they know my story, they get to mentor me in different aspects of life, and I think that's something that's really special as a college student, to have teachers who actually know you and care about your development as a Bible student, but also just as a disciple of Jesus, and they're invested in our spiritual development, and that's stayed consistent. You have not found out about the Institute by mistake. It was not an accident that you found out about the Institute. If you want to serve God and help people, God brought me to the best place to be able to do that and to prepare me to be a missionary. So that is my message.
Yeah. No, thanks, that was great.
Yes.